Hello everyone! Welcome back to a new tutorial. Today, we're diving into the exciting world of LCD displays. In this tutorial, we'll be learning how to connect an LCD display to an Arduino board and write Arduino on the screen, as you can see here. Don't worry if you're new to this, we'll take it step by step. So, open up your Tinkercad tab and let's get started. First, let's understand the basics. The LCD stands for liquid crystal display, and it is a flat panel display used for electronically displaying information. It's commonly used in various devices, including our Arduino projects. Our typical LCD display here has a row of pins that serve different functions. The display we are going to use has two rows. The first row is row 0, and the second row is row 1. And each line has 16 columns, numbered from 0 to 15. That is why this display is called 16x2 display. Now let's talk about the function of each pin. We have the LED backlight pins that are used to turn on and off the backlight of the display. Then, we have 8 data pins from DB0 to DB7. These pins are used to transfer data between the display and the Arduino board. We also have the enable pin that should be held high to enable the display communication. Then, we have a read and write pin that controls if the data flow corresponds to a reading or a writing command from Arduino. Another pin is the select register pin that is responsible for selecting which internal register is currently active. The LCD display has two main registers, the command register and the data register. The command register stores the command instructions given to the LCD, for example, clearing its screen. And the data register stores the data to be displayed on the LCD. We also have a contrast pin that is connected to a potentiometer to adjust the display contrast. And finally, we have VCC and GND for power supply. Now, let's go to Tinkercad to make the connections between the LCD and the Arduino board. So, here I have already grabbed my Arduino board, the breadboard, and the LCD display. Please notice that I got this LCD here and not the I2C model. I am going to make another video soon explaining the difference between them. I also made the 5 volts and ground connections to the breadboard, and I put the potentiometer here. Now, let's start with the wiring. First, we are going to connect the VCC and the ground pins to power up the display. I am also going to change the color of the wire. Let's put red for VCC and black for the ground. Then, we have the contrast pin that we are going to connect on the middle pin of the potentiometer. The other two pins of the potentiometer go to the VCC and to the ground. The next pin is the register select, and we are going to connect it on pin 12 of the Arduino board. The read and write pin is connected to the ground line of the breadboard, which means that the Arduino is executing a writing task on the display. The enable pin goes to pin 11 of the Arduino. Now, as I said in the beginning of the video, we have 8 pins from DB0 to DB7 used to transfer data. Each character of the display is coded as an 8-bit information, and we can use the display in two different modes, which are the 8-bits mode, in which we use all 8 pins from DB0 to DB7, and the 4-bits mode, in which we use only 4 pins from DB4 to DB7. The main difference between the two modes is the data transfer speed, but in practice this difference is not significant for us. Based on that, we are going to use the 4-bits mode, so that we can use only 4 pins of the Arduino. As the Arduino Uno board has a limited amount of pins, it is better to use only the minimum necessary for the display, and then use the rest of the pins for other input or output sensors. In a future video, I am going to show you how to use the LCD, together with a serial board, called I2C, which allow us to connect the display to the Arduino board using only a few pins. Let's make the data connection with the Arduino. The DB7 pin goes to pin 7. The DB6 goes to pin 6. The DB5 goes to pin 5. And, finally, the DB4 goes to pin 4. The last two pins correspond to the LED backlight of the display. The LED anode goes to the VCC. And the LED cathode goes to the ground line in the breadboard. But first we need to add a series resistor of 220 ohms. Now that we finished the connections with our LCD, let's jump into our code. The first thing we need to do is to add the LCD library. This library includes the necessary header file, which is essential for controlling LCD displays. In Tinkercad, we already have a list of libraries that we can use. In our case, we need to use this library here. You can see that the library importation automatically appeared in our code. The next command is the liquid crystal LCD command. This command has 6 parameters. Let's put a comment on that. The first parameters is the Arduino pin number that was connected to the register select pin of the LCD. The second parameter is the Arduino pin number that was connected to the enable pin of the LCD. And the next 4 parameters are the Arduino pins that were connected to the data pins of the LCD, which are DB4, DB5, DB6, and DB7. In our case, if you go back to the circuit connections, the parameters for our function should be 12, 11, 4, 5, 6, and 7. In the void setup function, we are going to add the LCD begin function. This function is used to initialize the LCD and specify the number of columns and rows on the display. The first parameter is the number of columns, which is 16. And the second parameter is the number of rows, which is 2. Then, in the void loop function that will be executed repeatedly, we are going to add the lcd.print function. This function sends the text Arduino to the LCD display, causing it to display the word Arduino on the screen. Let's also add a 2 seconds delay in our code, because in sequence, we are going to add the lcd.clear function. This function clears the LCD screen, removing the displayed text from the screen. This prepares the display for any subsequent messages that need to be shown. And finally, let's add another delay of 1 second. And that is it. Let's review our code. We added the library that has all the functions that allow us to control the LCD display. Then, we informed which pins of the Arduino board is connected to the LCD. In the void setup, we initialized the LCD display and informed its character dimensions. In the void loop, we are showing on the display the text Arduino. Wait 2 seconds. Clear it. And wait 1 second until the process repeats again. Let's check how our code works. Let's press the simulation button. Right now, we cannot see anything on the display. If this happens to you, check the potentiometer. If we rotate it, we can increase the display contrast to see the text. And there you have it. The Arduino text appears for 2 seconds, and then it is cleared from the display. And the cycle repeats. I hope this tutorial has given you a solid foundation for working with LCD displays in your future Arduino projects. In future videos, we will explore more complex projects that involve real-time data display or user interaction. The possibilities are endless, so keep exploring and creating. Thank you for joining me today. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more exciting Arduino content. Feel free to leave your questions and comments down below. Until next time, happy coding and happy tinkering!